Hello, everybody, and welcome to another Minecraft episode. This time, as you can see, I'm not on Castia. This isn't Castia. This is actually the Battle for Conwy Castle, or sometimes it's called the Dark Age. I played on this server about a year ago. I started playing on it. It's a team game. It's not just straight, like, one versus one PvP or free-for-all PvP. And I like that kind of element of the game, so I decided to hop back on here for a little while and play some team games. What you have to do here, actually, it's really unique. It's a capture the flag game mode. It's not just straight team deathmatch. That's part of it. But the other part of it is all of these. Each one of these colored blocks stands for a different flag, and your team controls that flag, and when you do control that flag, you can spawn there. So as you can see, I'm on the blue team here. We're playing as the Dutch. This map in particular has three different teams. It has the Dutch, it has the English, and I'm completely honest here, I don't remember what the other ones were. Actually, see if I can do, is it slash team? Nope. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to do slash team, someone on that team. Okay, that's right, it was the Portuguese. They're playing as the Portuguese. And when you're playing, you have the choice of, if you're a non-donor, you can use swordsman, spearman, archer, or fire archer. I've never actually used fire archer. I always play as swordsman. The rest of the other classes are all donor classes. They're really fun. I don't have any on this account, but on my other account, I have one for engineer. And it's really fun. I like engineer. I'm just going to hop in there. Let's just go play and see what this map is like. There's a bunch of maps on here, actually. Oh, someone took it. They just took it. Okay, so we're spawning here. There's a bunch of maps, actually, if I do slash map. Wait. There we go. Actually, slash map's going to tell me which one we're currently on. Slash maps, that's the full list of maps. There's a lot of them in here, and you probably noticed that there's a couple Lord of the Rings maps. This server is all, like, medieval-style gameplay, and I'm not... no, thank you. No. No, thank you. That's just too much of a battle right there. I can't take all them out. But as you can tell from the classes and the game style here, this one is not as medieval. It's more of kind of... It's like 1500s, I guess. 1600s when they're capturing the ancient ruins of, like, I don't know, it's probably like the Mayan ruins or something like that. It's a pretty fairly new map, and it hasn't been out for that long, so I really don't know where everything is in here. I know where there's like three flags, and I get lost trying to find the other ones. It is a little bit of a confusing map to play, but it's fun nonetheless. And he's going to kill me, so I'm just going to run away. My favorite maps on here, though, there's another guy up there. Okay, this isn't fun. I'm not liking this. Too many people. Normally when I play on this map, since I don't really get a chance to come on here during the day as much, let's just see if we can take, where'd he go, there it is. I normally play on this at night, and this server is from the Netherlands, so it's got more of a European following to it. So when I get on here to play, he's still following me. When I get on here to play, all like the European players are in bed. Or when I get on in the afternoon, my time, they're at school or wherever they happen to be. So I don't really get a chance playing this that much. I'm going to die. I'm just going to die. But there's also some really cool aspects about this server. Most of them aren't on this map in general. It's more on the castle maps, which are my personal favorite. Is he still following me? I don't know. I'm just gonna keep running for it. There's actually working catapults and cannons on some of them. This one doesn't have it because there's obviously no cannons here. But it's really cool. It's custom coded, so you can go up to a catapult, and if there's a piece of cobblestone in it, being like the rocks you're going to throw, you can actually change the coordinates of it and fire it at the walls of the castle, and it actually does damage to the environment. Like, I don't know many PvP servers where you can actually damage to the environment during gameplay, so you can kind of hop in and do whatever you have to do, raid the castle, or just kind of blow people up with it. Most of them are just static maps. This one is like, it's a changing map as you're playing on it, if they have those features in there. And it's really cool. I like it. Oh, that's good. The guys are my team. Let's see. We only have three maps right now. Three flags right now. So let's go see. I honestly don't know where most of them are. Except for this one. I know. What is this? They're going as a team. As I said, this is a team-based game, and they are playing as a team, and I'm not right now. I should probably start playing as a team. I can find my teammates. I've seen like three. I don't know where they all are. But this place is being pretty much dominated in this area by the Portuguese. This one's a little bit more difficult too, with three different teams. All the other maps, they have two teams on them. This one, I believe, is the only one with three, so it kind of makes it a little bit more difficult. But also, if you like exploring, this is like the perfect server for exploring. I completely did not plan this out. I'm gonna be honest, I did not plan this out. But if you're exploring, there's a guy over there. Let me just do this quick. So yeah, that's a secret. Okay, I'm running. There's secrets in this map. If you do /secret, there's a certain amount for each map. And it's just like a fun Easter egg thing to find. I wish this guy would stop following me. Okay, that guy needs... Okay, I'm just gonna kill him. I'm just gonna kill him. Where is he? No, he's gonna kill me. Okay. Well, okay, now I can do it. /secrets. As you can see, I've only found three. And I found... Oh, I didn't even click on it. That's right. I found that secret on my other account, and I have like 30 secrets on that one, I think. But I forgot to click on it in this one. But they just kind of add up to your score for top. There's top lists for like everything in here. Top secrets. And as you can see, there's players on who have found them all. And it doesn't really change anything. It just gives you something to do. But like the top list is where it's at. Top list is where it's at. They've got heals for medics, captures for flags, repairs for... Just as an engineer, you can repair things. You can see that on a different map. Not really this one. Like, when I was talking earlier about being able to... Stop capturing the ruined street. We have, like, one here. I don't like this. One. But as you blow up the map with the catapults, the cannons, and everything like that, you can go in as an engineer, and you can replace the blocks that were destroyed. So let's say you were blowing up a ship. There's a map called Rum Rage. It's just completely... Okay, here we go. It's just completely like a colonial versus pirates little battle with ships, cannons, and everything. But if you're blowing up the enemy ship... Where's this guy? If you're blowing up the enemy ship and then you capture it with your own flag, you can then have an engineer, or if you have the engineer class, just switch over to engineer and replace all of the wood that was destroyed on the ship. It takes a while, but it gives you a ton of points, so all the classes in here are balanced, and the engineer class is balanced in the way where it's a terrible fighter. It's terrible at fighting, but it has its maneuvers to be able to use traps, where you can place on the ground. You place traps around, and if someone steps on it, they'll take damage. So that's kind of a defensive right there, and it also has, I think it has a jump boost. I don't think it has speed. What is this? Go away. I don't think it has, like, speed or anything, but I'm pretty sure it has a jump boost. And you can get away from enemies quicker. So it's like it's almost like a Team Fortress 2. Okay, these guys are coming. That's too much. I can't take them on right now while I'm talking. It's like Team Fortress 2, where you have the engineer. Theirs is a little bit slower, but it can fight better. You can fight with the engineer. But on this one, you can't really fight with the engineer. It has a stone sword and some leather armor, so it doesn't have much. Where's this guy? He's coming? Yeah, he's coming. So you really can't do much to defend yourself. You can do a little bit, but if you're fighting any more than one person, you're going to die. So you can get away really quickly with those things, and it's really fun. It's a completely different way to play with each class that you have on here. Like all the donor classes, each one is balanced in their own way, has its own weaknesses, has its own benefits, and you have to adapt to a different play style. So it's like an ever-changing way to play the game. It's great. We're not doing so well here. We're doing pretty bad. What I'm going to do, actually, is I'm going to cut here for a couple minutes until we get closer to the end, and maybe if we win, then cool. But if not, I'm going to show up another map. Which one was next? Next was Contario. It's one of the original maps, and it's really cool. That one is one that has catapults in it. So I'm going to cut here, and I'm going to show you guys that in a minute here. Alright, here we go. Minutes have passed, and as you can see, we've been completely dominated this match. And to me, it looks like my team here has given up. Just been standing around here, I guess. We just got something else. Okay, we weren't dominated as bad as I thought, but they gave up. That's the way it goes on the server, I guess. Some of the best PvPers I've ever played against are on this server. Like, and a lot of people don't even know it exists, since it's from Netherlands. Not many people know this thing exists, and it's still a small server. It only supports like 120, 150 people. If you don't have VIP, you can't get in past when there's a maximum of like 100 people. But the players on here, the really good players, won't play anywhere else. They've been playing here for like years. And if you want a good challenge, just come over here. You'll get a really good challenge fighting these guys. But as I said, we're on a map here now, Contario. This one, see, it's like a castle. This is one of the original maps. Well, not, it wasn't completely original, but one of the earlier ones. And I'm actually gonna switch. Let's switch to the Savage Horde. And as a Savage Horde, we get this one down here. There's one spawn point. Starts as our red camp. This is one of the maps where these blue guys up here, which are the Contario Guard, they cannot take this. There are certain maps where attacking teams cannot have their spawns taken by the other team. And this is one of them. So I'm gonna start there, but first, I'm really curious about Fire Archer, and I think I'm gonna try it out. Even though I'm terrible with a bow, but let's see what happens. All right, Fire Archer. Okay, we got fire pits. Oh, there must be like is it like those things that the you know like in they have the medieval movies where they have the lava. Nah, well, it would be lava here because you can't do anything else. But it's like hot oil or hot water. They pour it off a side. I wonder if that's what that is. But what do we have? What's on this bow? It's power one bow, fire pit. So I think, wait, no, maybe you put the fire pit down and then it allows you to do fire. Oh, let's go find out. Let's go find out. Let's go find out. We're gonna try it. All right, we're gonna spawn here. Spawning in the floor. Okay. All right. Oh, wait. I think, oh, this has slowness on it. Does this have slowness? Oh, it has slowness too. Oh, I hate things with slowness on them. Well, I'm here anyway. I'll show you this. This is the catapult. Someone's already fired it, but you can see, have they all been fired? That's fire. Okay, so there's fire. But there's one over there. See? It looks like that, where it's just kind of down. And when it's down like that, and if I ever get over there with the slowness too, you get this. It's a cobblestone half slab, and it makes it look like it's got ammo in it. And then you got these over here, these two signs. One aims it up, one aims it down. And what, well, this aims it up and down, this one aims it left and right. So putting it in a negative will push it. Yeah, it'll put it in that direction over there. And that's a little high. I don't even know what the good like ratio is for this one. But then you come up here and you fire the catapult. And it fires the stone, goes over there. I probably completely missed and it probably went over the walls and everything. But it's still really cool. It's a really fun way to get into castles. You just blast your way through. And then let's see if our team has made any hits yet. Show you what it looks like here. They have actually, they have. This over here shouldn't be like this. It should just come straight down. So someone already hit the catapult into this spot, and it looks like it's been patched up a little bit from the engineer, possibly the engineers, maybe. I think maybe they were doing that. I'm getting sniped here by those guys. All right. Okay, so I'm gonna take this seriously. I'm gonna go try using the fire archer. So I'm gonna see what it's like. But the catapults are really fun to use. It takes a while to master them, and sometimes people like to come up and just fire them when you're still aiming them, and it gets kind of annoying. But if you're an engineer, as soon as this goes down, normally when it goes down without ammo in it. But if you're an engineer, you can actually place ammo in it and fire it twice as fast as normal. No one's touched that one yet, but let's just see what we can do here. Fire pit goes down. And I really don't know how this works. I honestly do not know how this works. How does this work? I don't know. I honestly don't know. And you pick it back. Wait, you pick it back up. I'm so confused. I don't know what this is. Do I have anything else? No. There's usually a description for all of these things. I don't know who's shooting me. I'd really appreciate it if they didn't. Really appreciate it if they didn't. Oh, what it might be is one of the donor classes actually is a crossbow. And they're probably up there. It has a huge range because it doesn't have like arrows, they have the drop on them. Crossbowman doesn't have a drop on it. So it's pretty fun to use. You just hide way in the back of the map and just snipe people from a distance. But it's a slow moving class. Like, you cannot fire repeatedly with it. There's somebody up there. Yay! You cannot fire repeatedly with it. And you have to wait until you get to full draw on your bow, and then there's a 2 second reload. And you also don't have any other weapon other than that. So if someone were to come up to you with like a sword, you have no way of protecting yourself. Go away. That's why I hate Archer. I'm bad at it. I think I'm gonna go back to. I'm gonna go back to swordsman. I'm just gonna break into this castle now. No more fooling around. Right, let's go. But yeah, if you click on these things, it tells you what they get. But unfortunately, fire archer is not working. So I don't actually know how to use it. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. But so far, we're making progress. We have North Tower, Red Camp, and Village. So North Tower is all the way over there. So what they probably did is they start in Red Camp, and it says we have the Village, but it's under attack. So one of the strategies for this one is you start here, and you wrap your way around over here to the Village. You take the Village, and then you can just kind of follow your way over here and go around to the back of the castle, and then you just put up ladders on the backs of the tower over there, and you can just kind of get right in. That's what they must have did here. Oh, that's a playable class too. There's actually a Warhound class. It morphs you into a wolf, and you can go around killing people. It's fantastic. I don't have that one, though. I don't have that one. I'm so sad. The only one that I still have is the Engineer. I used to have the Crossbowman, and it was my favorite class, but I only had it for a short period of time because there's two ways to get classes in here. You can either buy it as a temporary class, and it costs usually 5 euros. Everything on the server is done in euros since it's from the Netherlands, but it was 5 euros for some classes, 10 euros for other classes, and it would get you 90 days. Or you can buy it permanently. Like, I think a 5 euro class that's normally 90 days would actually be, I think it's 15 euros or something like that. You get to keep it. So it's kind of cool because you get to try out, if you're not sure about a class and you're it's only 5 euros or $7 or something like that. And you're I'll just give it a shot for 90 days. And if you like it and you're still playing the server at that point, which a lot of people still play the server. What's that? Oh, that's that class. Let me kill this person. That class over there with no armor is a berserker. They're really annoying. What they do is they have no armor and they have just a sword. And they also get a potion. I don't know where he went. He's probably dead. I hope he's dead. I hate these guys. And you get the potion. It's called a berserker potion. And it gives you a damage bonus and a ridiculous speed bonus. Here he is. There he is. See? I don't think he's using it yet. I think they get a speed bonus to begin with. And then they also get another one. And they're hard to kill if you're alone. Because the people who play this have mastered it. It's really hard to use because you get nausea when you use the potion. So it takes a while to kind of get the hang of it and play it. But it's used to wipe out small groups of archers. Or just small groups of anything if you're really good. Some of the people that play with the Berserker are just ridiculous with it. It's really hard to kill them. And when you go in there, you just expect that you're going to die. It's the point of the class is to get a certain amount of kills and then die. And somebody's... Yeah, see, this is the damage I was talking about. These are all done by catapults. So if someone... I'm going to go kill this guy. Whoa, what? What was that? Wow, okay, that was a really, really... I'm upset. Shouldn't be able to hit me like that. I'm upset. Let's go back up there. My goal now is to kill this person. I'm going to kill this person. Let's go back and kill him. Let's go back. But yeah, if I had my engineer class on here, I'd probably go patch up those walls. And, it's another thing I never actually mentioned yet. This thing right here. See this? This is a restock chest. So as you use your... you have ladders... And you have stake for all the classes. And some of the other classes have bonus materials, like an archer is going to have arrows because they don't have infinity bows. You have to kind of plan out. You have to have a strategy. Oh, there's an engineer. There's an engineer. Oh, they killed him. Oh, see? There's a trap. And I stepped on some, I think, because I took a lot of damage. Whoa, he came back up again. Okay, I'm going to put a hit out on this guy very soon. I'm going to put a hit out on this guy. Oh, that's right. You can do voting here, too. You can just vote for different things. Sharp sword, feather fall. One for more ladders. Another one for an extra half heart. Another stake. And it lasts for 24 hours. But let's go kill this guy. Let's go kill him. But as I was saying, and there's another class. Another good example of that would be the engineer class. Where the engineer class, it has a certain amount of items it could use. as far as repair items. I think you get 16 pieces of wood, 16 pieces of stone or cobblestone, and you use those to repair. Once you're out, you have to go restock at one of those restock chests. So there's a strategy to it. You can't just go into battle and just like, I'm gonna kill everybody, because you have to kind of watch your materials like it would be in an actual battle. And sometimes you have to backtrack. Oh, no! No! Come on. Somebody needs to patch that up. That's annoying. But at, like an actual battle, you can't just go out and assume you have infinite resources. So it brings in like an aspect of realism into Minecraft battling. It's fun. And this is actually the only server that I've seen that does it this way. And wow, are you serious? Come on. Go for someone else. I get a little bit of lag since I'm connecting from like across the ocean to this. So when I first spawn in, it takes me like a second or two to be able to move. Or see, I spawn down there, I get a little bit of lag. But you get used to it, because it kind of dies down after that. Okay, I'm gonna see if I can kill this guy now. Let's see if I can kill this guy. Wait! Oh, he took it! He took my kill! It was supposed to be mine, all mine. That one's mine, though. Okay. Anyway, as you've probably seen, the flag capturing works. You just kind of stand next to the flag, and it goes down. This one's not gonna go down because we own this flag. This one's ours. Hold on 1 second. I'm gonna go over there. Go over there. Hold on. All right. So the tides of the battle have actually changed since the last time. So I had to go somewhere else to find one of these I was gonna show you. Die. Oh. Maybe this isn't gonna work either. But see these flags? You just stand next to them. As you stand next to them, you'll get a message in your chat if there's no enemies near you trying to kill you as you're doing it, stealing their flag. And what it's gonna do is it should work now as long as those guys stay over there. Yep, there you go. See? It says you're capturing a flag in your chat. So this is what you're supposed to do to gain more ground when you're fighting. So see how it's going down? As it goes down, it lowers to a neutral point. And then when it hits the neutral point, if you're still here and it's not contested with an enemy, it changes to your color and raises back up. So the point of this is to try and get as many spawn points as possible to make it easier for you to fight in the battle and spawn at different points on the map. And the game is over when the attackers are able, or if they are able, to go and destroy all of the enemy defenses and get into their base or castle, or whatever you want to call it, and take all of their flags. Like, see, we only have one left up there to take, and that's the King's Tower, and it's really hard to get over there. So I don't know if we're going to be able to do that or not, but I'm not going to count on it, because it's really fortified up there. And everybody that would be able to spawn at the other towers are now restricted to spawning to that one tower. That's their last one they can spawn at. We have, as you can see on the right-hand side, we have all of the rest. So that's pretty much the point of this game, and I know I kind of talked a lot through this whole thing, but I know a lot of you that watch my videos have never seen the server before, and I kind of wanted to do like an informative thing on here before I actually do like gameplay videos and everything. I want to come back. I want to do more. There's more maps that we can do, and there's more that are actually coming out soon. I know there's like two in the works right now, maybe more. And they get swapped out every so often. Sometimes a map will replace another one. So there's always an ever-changing aspect on here. There's more. Oh, that is a. Whoa. Oh, somebody got crazy with the catapult over here. Somebody got really crazy with the catapult. Oh my. Oh, okay. Pull down there. But anyway, there'll be more content to show. There'll be more to show you guys, and I'm looking forward to it. So for those who do play the server, watch my videos. I hope I did a good job. It's been a while since I've actually like religiously played on the server like I used to. And hopefully you guys will stop by next time to watch another episode of this when I do another map. All right, see you guys later.